I thought I'd be away for a month or two, but it turned out that the time had passed way too long and we have to keep the channel alive. So in this tutorial I'll go quickly through the webcam stand making, and since this is not too hard to model, this tutorial won't have any advanced techniques. So let's get straight to the point. So after you create a new project, we need to start with the body feature, meaning we are making one single part. We also have to be in the part design workbench. If you need default data planes visible, simply select the origin in the model tree and press space. Otherwise, from the view menu, choose toggle visibility. Next, create the sketch and select the XZ data plane, meaning we'll draw on the front plus side. Then use the polyline to draw the two lines along the axis, and to switch between the modes you can use the M key, but in this case I'll use endpoints and rim point arc. With the arc active, choose both ends of the polyline, then an approximate radius, and right click to cancel the feature. To make the arc in the upper angle perpendicular to the line, choose both lines and assign the perpendicular constraint. To assign vertical dimension or distance constraint, you can choose both endpoints or the line itself. Same for the bottom line. Once the sketch turns green, we know that the sketch is complete and we can close the sketch now. With the sketch selected, choose the revolve feature and use the default settings. Start the new sketch and use the same datum plane. To have better visibility, switch to wireframe shading mode. For some reason, pop-up menus do not always show up while recording. Choose polyline and do all the same as for the first sketch, but with the new dimensions as shown. While the sketch is still active, we'll use the groove feature. What this feature does, it takes out the portion we don't need, but in the same manner as the revolve feature do. We need to remove some additional portions from the model, so create a new sketch and use the polyline to draw shape with the dimensions as shown. If you need to constrain the point to the line, have both selected and from the constraint toolbar choose point on the object. Then select two points on the right and assign the vertical constraint with 25 mm in length. For the distance from the origin, select only the closest vertex to the origin, and right after, use the corresponding constraint. Make it 30 millimeters from the origin, and the bottom line also 30 millimeters. To assign an angle constraint, select two lines where you need to edit, and from the constraint toolbar, apply the angle and make it 120 degrees. Close the sketch, but now we'll use the pocket feature to remove the unwanted portion from the model. Because we need to remove the material on the both sides, make symmetric to plane option active. Simply type 100, but the through all pocket type should work as well. Now we need this feature in three equal directions instead of one. To do this, we'll use polar pattern feature, and in the feature dialog for the main rotational axis, choose Z, and for the occurrences, type 3. For the mounting point, we are going to add a bit of reinforcement first. So start the sketch and use the same datum plane as before. Switch to the wireframe shading mode and draw three lines as shown. Use the point at the object constraint to align the polyline to the vertical axis. Constrain the vertical line with a 6.5 mm in length, and as before, select only closest vertex to the origin and assign the vertical constraint with the 14 mm in length. What I'm doing now, I could have used a single polyline, but I choose to add these additional lines individually. So add a line on the right, and each end should be constrained to the corresponding point on the top and the bottom using the coincident constraint. To make the corners round, select two lines and apply fillet feature on both corners and make them equal using the equal constraint. While arc is selected, add the radius of 1. Choose one of two points on the right, one from the left, and apply horizontal constraint with the length of 8 millimeters, and the sketch should be completed. While sketch is active, apply a revolve feature with the default settings. And the last thing, We'll add the hole for the bolt, for example. So create a sketch on the top plane and add the circle. For the easier preview, you can switch to the wireframe shading mode. Make sure that the circle starts from the origin. It will be automatically constrained to the origin. Apply the diameter constraint and type 6 millimeters. Lastly, while sketch is selected, apply pocket feature and for the type choose through all. In case the pocket do not show up, you only need to reverse the direction. And that is all for this tutorial. If you like, you can play a little with the colors, and I hope this tutorial helps for certain areas of modeling, or especially if you're starting to use the Freecad. So see you all in the next tutorial. Happy New Year and have a nice day.